My name's Tom Grundy. I'm the editor-in-chief of Hong Kong Free Press. I'm originally from England, but I've been in Hong Kong for 10 years, reported quite closely on the Occupy movement, and have just launched a new independent news source for Hong Kong. There is an underutilized, I think, watchdog status for media in Hong Kong, where they can really keep to account the government in the mainland. There is no top-down censorship here. But there is self-censorship, and it's through commercial and political pressures that we don't see the level of criticism that we should in this one free corner of China. There are, you know, some concerns at the SCMP, their editorials. It seems to be just taking a more pro-establishment or pro-Beijing stance. So, you know, we hope to be very impartial. We are not pro-Beijing or pro-democracy, and we welcome a diversity of voices on our platform. We'll just be sticking to the facts with our hard news beat. We have, you know, 9 or 10 different income streams, so we're not reliant on one or two, to ensure that we can actually remain independent and survive. Just in the last month, during our crowdfunding round, we had the biggest, most successful campaign they've ever hosted. And could you call on HKU contact, so we should be picking up the phone now more as we're going towards launch?
Yeah, it's on the calendar.
Great. We really underestimated, I think, just the appetite people have for a new English independent voice in Hong Kong. There's been a flourishing of independent Chinese media in Hong Kong, but nothing on the English side really, and we saw some of that gap in English during the Occupy protest. There was a great South China Morning Post live blog, but you know, it was axed halfway through. So we want to give that kind of minute-by-minute coverage to what's happening in post-Occupy Hong Kong, and that timing is really vital at the moment. It's after those umbrella movement protests and in the run-up to these key 2017 elections that will kind of define Hong Kong's place in China and its future towards 2047, when its autonomy and special status is meant to expire. So we'll be reporting upon and keeping, you know, a close eye on Hong Kong's development and its autonomy over the coming decades.